God! Help me! Crawford! They're coming! I can smell them!
You were right, Doctor. It's hopeless. What will you do? I think he would have liked to see his works donated to the British Museum.
Mr. Parker, your comet story has a great deal of promise. Tell me, 76 years after the Bulliskin business, do you really think...
Thank you. he stumbled over something extraordinary at Ilsmouth. His writings and sketches are proof of it.
Yes, but he came home a raving lunatic. I don't want to go on any wild goose chases.
You'll have solid proof, Mr. Griffith. I'll go to Ilsmouth. I'll find the exact place where Boleskine made his sketches. I'll take photographs.
If I finance your trip, and if you take the first steamship to America, will you be there in time for the passage of the comet?
I'll be there with 3 nights to spare before Halley's comet passes. I've already arranged to stay with a local doctor, a fella called Cobble.
Well, I'm willing to take a chance. I just hope this is worth it.
Mr. Griffith, your readers are going to love you.
Bring me back some sensational photographs. I want hard evidence of everything you say. I cannot afford to print crackpot ideas.
Mr. Parker, I presume?
Dr. Cobble? Delighted to make your acquaintance.
Allow me to introduce you to Andrew Arlington, the mayor of our little community.
Very happy to meet you.
Thank you, sir. I'm very glad to meet you.
There's no time to lose, Mr. Parker. We'd best be on our way. The Sales Brothers have delivered your luggage. There's a telegram for you. It's in your room.
Thank you.
Dr. Cobble tells me you're interested in stars.
And comets.
Comets? I guess your visit has something to do with Halley's Comet.
Indeed. And Ilsmouth appears to be a marvelous place from which to observe the sky at night.
Oh, is that so?
If it's a clear night, we shall see the comet soaring through the sky.
You sure know how to project your enthusiasm, Mr. Parker.
Well, here you are, all set to get to work. I'll show you to your room. I'll have to leave you, my customers.
Won't wait. Just like the worthy citizens of my little town. Have a wonderful visit, Mr. Parker.
Yes, welcome to Ilsmouth. I reserved the big room on the first floor for you. Tell me if you need anything.
Don't worry, I have everything I need. Goodbye, Doctor, and thank you again. Absorbent cotton and surgical spirit. Let's leave them here. Now, let's see. The camera, a tripod, the lantern, the map of the area, but... Oh, thank goodness. They didn't forget Boliskin's original drawing, the one I purchased at Christie's. I'll leave my things in this trunk for the moment. Tuesday, February 12th. I at last found a young villager willing to guide me through the forest for payment. Wednesday, February 13th. Good God, what a sight to see! The stars seemed a rifle shot away. This place must be a window to some other dimension. This evening I will take my material. Thursday, February 14th. This child of 12 is remarkable. A great deal brighter and livelier than the village children, who seem a sorry lot. He held the torches while I drew new constellations upon the map, undoubtedly inaccurate, given the position of the river. I have named them Octopus, Stalker. They are quite frightening. I have noted the place. I'll be there when Halley's Comet passes, and then... If the child was 12 years of age in 1834, he's 88 today. There's a chance he's still alive. The town records will have the information. From Sales and Brothers, London, to Mr. Parker in Dr. Cobble Estate. Apologies. Stop. Have no more photosensitive plates. Stop. Try to purchase some your end. Stop. Fine picture. Thank you.
with you right away, sir. No problem, Mr. Hambledon. That'll be delivered tonight. Oh, I spoke to Miss Gilchrist. She got your package. Can I help you, sir?
I'd like some photosensitive plates, please.
Well, just hold on a few seconds while I check to see if I have any. You're a lucky man! Well, they do say if anybody sells it, Meyer does. Got two boxes left. There's one. $10 for three plates.
I'll take them.
My advice to you is to try them first. I've had them for quite a while, so they aren't exactly brand new.
Oh, really?
That's a fact. Daytime, night, outside, inside. What is it you're wanting to photograph?
The stars in the night sky.
Well, you be careful. The emulsion's kind of old. Tell you what, you take a few shots of whatever you want to photograph and see what sort of results you get. If those plates aren't perfect, I'll give you your money back. And if they're okay, well, you can go back and buy some more.
I'll take your advice. Page of Boliskin's writing. Wednesday, February 13th. Good God, what a sight. The stars were no more than a pistol shot away. That's curious. The word pistol has been crossed out and replaced by rifle. And a handwritten note. Truth sleeps beneath the pyramids. J. Keats. Interesting.
I've been expecting you. Oh, don't be surprised. Passing scientists invariably pay me a short visit. Of course, they're a rare breed around here now. Not like in the old days. But you don't want to hear all that. Allow me to introduce myself. Tobias John, keeper of the archives and records, at your service.
There's probably nothing I can tell you that you don't already know.
Mr. Parker. I may know your name and profession, but not the reason for your visit.
I'd like to consult the birth register.
So, your interests are not limited to the stars. I hope I may be able to quench part of your thirst for knowledge. But remember, there are more things in heaven and earth, Horatio, than are dreamt of in your philosophy. Now, who the devil wrote that?
Shakespeare.
Excellent. So, Mr. Parker, you like to read?
I like nothing better than a good read.
Books are my passion, Mr. Parker. My most precious companions. Silent, discreet, sometimes filled with mystery. I must let you get on with your work.
Fortunately, there weren't too many births in 1822. According to the register, there are three still alive today. Curtis Hambleton, William Coldstone, Thomas Greenwood.
Satisfied?
I believe I've found what I was looking for.
There are times when believing is not good enough, Mr. Parker. Sometimes we must be absolutely sure. Take Ilsmouth, for instance. For many years, the locals believed in the old legends. Did that make them true? I have a number of documents on the subject.
Fascinating. That's a subject I'm very keen on.
My library is full of such material, and I'm not talking about a mere single room. Oh, no. A lifelong study, you know. There are those who would dearly love to get their hands on some of those old papers, but they'll need to be smart.
Well, they do say there's no such thing as a perfectly guarded secret, Mr. Jug. Think of Oedipus's Sphinx.
Well, you're close to the mark there, Mr. Parker. But I'd better let you get on with your work. Come back any time. The records are open in the afternoons. I'm usually at home in the morning. My house is just right of the post office. Just ring whenever you want. I'll tell you some interesting stories.
Interesting.
You're a likable young fellow. I happened to glance over your shoulder while you were consulting the register, and I may be able to save you some time. Greenwood, lives in the house right next door to Dr. Cobble's. Coalstone's house is set back a little from my own. Curtis Hambleton lives in the abandoned fishery near the harbor.
I don't know how to thank you.
Just promise to pay me another visit. Glad to have been of help. Oh, by the way, if you're interested in local history, take a look in the next room. Want to talk? I'll be at home.
A pair of broken binoculars. Would Jug be spying on somebody? The papers of no interest. Magnifying glass. Mr. Hambleton? Curtis Hambleton? 76 years ago, a British scientist, Lord Bolliskin.
Don't mention that name to me. Bad luck and trouble. I led him around for 3 nights. I carried the torch, the rifle, and I saw the thing.
What thing?
I wish I didn't remember. He'd drawn a map. I took him to the cross. I don't mind telling you, I was scared. Later on, I refused to go with my father to pray to the stones, so my father threw me out. My brother Wilbur cursed me, and now I live in squalid conditions.
Where did you take Boliskin?
Get away from this region, mister. The comet's coming back. It'll be here in 3 nights, and that thing's coming too. Wilbur said so, so just get away from Illsmouth while you've got time.
Why?
If you saw what I saw, it was on the third night in the forest near the Calvary. The English guy was drawing. Then the thing appeared. I'd pay any price to forget what I saw. Now, get lost. Shoo!
Find somewhere else to mess up. Say, Mr. Parker, Mr. Arlington, the mayor, told me about you. Welcome to Illsmouth. I'm Sergeant Baggs from the local police.
Glad to meet you. I'm looking for a cross.
Maybe you should try the cemetery. We call it the dead center of town. You get it?
I'm looking for a Calvary in the forest.
I can't help you there, and I don't advise you to wander in the forest by yourself. It's easy to get lost in that forest. I wouldn't even go there with a map. Now if you'll excuse me, duty calls. I've got to run those layabouts out of town towards the clearing in the woods.
What have they done?
They're gypsies, Mr. Parker. Sneakiest chicken thieves you ever saw. I'm not going to wait for them to strip the town bare, no sir. They're out of here.
Surely they have some rights.
I decide who has rights around here, Mr. Parker, and no stranger is going to tell me how to do my job. You stick to your science. I won't trouble you again.
But come now.
Mr. Parker, just read my lips. Stay out of my way.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, you, the fortune teller. Just shut up, okay? Now, you bunch of greaseballs, I want you out of my town, and I mean now. Mr. Parker, adieu.
Thank you.
on the butt. LB. Incredible. Jug has Boniskin's rifle. Oh, there's a message engraved in the gun. Dash it all. It's too small to read. If only I had a magnifying glass. It's badly written. Ah! Searcher. E-S-T. The rest has been rubbed away. Searcher. Suzanne Searcher, probably. Strange. Those names are not mentioned in Boniskin's notebooks.
I can't get our last conversation off my mind.
Have you found something?
Not yet. But I hope to shed light on a few interesting facts. We'll discuss them later on.
Nothing. Let's use the surgical spirit on the cotton. I was sure of it. The clue is not in the picture, but beneath it. Northeast beast, 4x2 stars. That's where the cross. I have to pinpoint the position of the cross on my map.
How's the photography going?
How's business?
Just fine. Now don't forget to test those plates I sold you.
Don't worry, I'll try them tonight. By the way, how well do you know the forest?
Really? Why?
I need a guide for tonight.
Go see Tyler. Nathan Tyler. He's a lighthouse keeper. He knows this region as well as anybody. You'll probably find him in the tavern.
Thanks for the tip. Do you know Wilbur Hamilton?
Just between you and me, he doesn't have a very good reputation, if you know what I mean. His two sons are no better, Obed and Benjamin. Well, I hope you're lucky enough never to meet any of them.
Lucky not to meet them. You make them sound like a heap of trouble.
Trouble is a nice way of saying it. Come to think of it, you already know Wilbur. The man with the hood in the general store this morning.
Yes, I remember.
That's business. You don't pick your customers. At least he pays, which not everybody does these days. You take care now, Mr. Parker.
Goodbye, Mr. Meyer. Ah, Dr. Cobble. I'm glad to see you.
Well, Mr. Parker, is the room satisfactory?
Couldn't be better, thank you. I need a guide to lead me through the forest tonight.
What? The forest? Well, don't count on me. My rheumatism, you see.
I wouldn't dream of imposing on you, Doctor, but I have no idea whom to ask.
Go in here and see Nathan Tyler, the lighthouse keeper. People speak well of him, but take care all the same.
Take care?
Well, he drives a tough bargain, I believe, so don't let him skin you alive. I hope you have a map. Otherwise...
I understand. Thank you, Doctor. May I offer you a drink?
Holy cow, no. I run the Temperance League with Miss Pickup. We're trying to get this den of iniquity shut down.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I had no idea.
To be honest, Miss Pickard bullied me into it. And I'll admit, I don't care too much for Zeke.
Ah, the unstoppable Miss Picot.
You understand perfectly. I have things to do. See you later.
Indeed, Doctor. Some information, please.
Does this look like a library? What are you drinking? $1.
Is that Nathan Tyler?
No, that's Thomas Bishop, a fisherman. Lives in the house in the harbor. First one you see when you arrive.
Is there something I can tell you?
No. Or rather, yes. I'm looking for Nathan Tyler.
He'll soon be here. You want to visit the lighthouse?
No. Are you familiar with the forest around Ilsmouth?
So-so? Why?
I want to go there tonight.
I see. You must be the astronomer. I don't think you'll find anyone to take you.
I was told that Tyler...
It's none of my business, but, you want to be careful of him.
Yes, I know. I've been warned about him. His prices.
No, not that. He's a strange... It's him.
For me.
You got it. There's a guy looking for you.
What for?
I'm told you know the forest well.
Shall we have a seat? Want to do some hunting, maybe? Get yourself a plump hare or a duck?
Not quite, no. Actually, I need a guide for tonight. I want to go to the Calvary in the forest.
That's quite a way. And I don't know if I remember the way leading there.
I have a map.
A map? Well, I wouldn't rely too much on it if I were you. I'll take you to the Calvary for $20.
$20? Isn't that a tiny bit steep?
Wait a minute. We have to cross the Washington River, you know. On a cold night, right in the middle of the forest. If you don't like my price, mister,
Parker.
Why didn't you say so? I'll take you there for nothing. Well, let's make it $5 for my expenses. We'll stop by at my place for something to eat, then we'll get ready and go. Okay? Thank you.
Benjamin.
If it ain't the Hambledon slime bags.
Obit, Ben. Stop that. Leave Webster alone.
Stay out of this, Bishop. I've been wanting to get me a Webster for quite a while now. Why, they're really laying into him.
Why don't you do something to stop them instead of making inane comments?
How about it, Webster? You like that? Want some more?
Let him be.
That's enough.
Mind your own damn business or I'll bust his nose. Thank you, sir.
I'm taking you to the drugstore.
You did the right thing, mister, but you'd better be on your guard from now on.
Father, quick! Somebody's hurt!
Holy cow, Walter Webster. I bet it was those Hambledon boys did this to you. Come over here.
You're a photographer, aren't you?
News travels fast around here, Miss.
Mary Matthews. I run the drugstore with my father. He's nuts about photography. Did you find what you were looking for, Mr. Parker?
Yes. Thank you.
My father is also a keen photographer.
Now that should keep him alive. Mr. Parker, I'm Jonathan Matthews. I hear you're a keen photographer. I have a darkroom which you're more than welcome to use if you want to develop your plates. You did a fine thing chasing off Benjamin and Obed. May the devil take those boys.
I'm grateful for your offer.
Come whenever you want, Mr. Parker.
Hold on to your horses, Mary.
So you're back on your feet.
Thanks to you, Mr. Parker. Without your help, I know you want to go into the forest. If I can help you...
Could you find your way to the Calvary? I have a map.
We can try. That'll be my way of thanking you.
Very well.
We'll meet in an hour outside the town hall.
See you later then.
Let's see what you brought. Okay, we have everything we need. I know this place very well. Let's go, I'll carry the tripod. There! That bush! It moved, didn't you see it? There's somebody spying on us for sure.
Calm down.
Listen, the cross is on the other side. I have to go home now.
If I took off that wrapping... Here, it's perfect. Fine, that seems to be holding. My tripod's none too stable. There, that should hold it in place. Fine. I'll be able to take some photos. There's a passage that way.
Feng Yui, Miluanyaf, Cthulhu Ryla, Wang Lia Nale Fatang. Feng Yui, Miluan Feng Yui, Miluanyaf. Cthulhu Ryla, Wang Lia Nale Fatang. Feng Yui, Miluan Yaf, Cthulhu Ryla, Wang Lia Nale Fatang. Behold! Look up there! We are being observed! Signed your own death warrant. I, Narakamos, tell you that in 2 nights, Cthulhu will reign once more. Cthulhu Ryla Wanglia Nale Fatang.
You're exhausted, been overdoing it, blood pressure a little high, too. You'll need a good, long rest.
Out of the question, Doctor.
Running the risk of a heart attack, so no excitement, you understand? Take this prescription along to Matthews right away. They're pills for your heart. Careful now. At the slightest twinge of pain in your left side, swallow one and fast. You got that?
I hear and obey, Doctor.
And no reckless pranks. You're young, but I'm only a physician, not a wizard.
Doctor, there's something I must tell you. I was chased by an Indian.
An Indian? Apart from Natawanga, who hides out in the forest, I don't see who it could be. There was a certain Naramus, I seem to recall, but he must be well and truly dead by now. If you meet him, ask him for the recipe for his elixir of eternal youth.
I'm not joking, Doctor.
That's what I was afraid of. I'm not a psychiatrist, you know. What you need is rest.
So, let's read the prescription. Mix 1 milligram of digitalin with 1 milligram of adrenaline. Okay. Take 1 pill in case of stress or overwork. Dear me, this manuscript is covered with weird signs. Thank you.
Doggone it all. I'll get all that ready for you. It's going to take a while.
I have a favor to ask. I must develop my plates, you see, and...
Help yourself. It's the door at the end. I'll be with you as soon as I've finished. In case you've forgotten, you need to develop and fix your plates. That requires mixing four different chemical products. You find the products you need to mix for each preparation on the shelf.
The chemicals seemed a little tired out. I'd better develop all the plates together. A few drops of metal. Let's continue. A dash of hydroquinone. Well, let's see the fixing solutions. Let's continue. The merest hint of sodium thiosulfate. Let's continue. A sniff of potash metabisulfite. No problem. Perfect. How horrific! My heart! Thank you. Thank you very much. Without you, I...
You see, that's a lot better already. Don't push your luck.
I'll try to remember that.
I'm counting on you. So is my daughter. That comes to $10. Thank you. Now I must leave you. Will you be all right?
Don't worry.
Drugstore's open from 8 to 6. If you need more pills, just stop by and ask.
Thank you again.
managed to develop your photographs, Mr. Parker?
Indeed, yes. Thank you. Statuette.
They came to find it. Great heavens, it's as I thought. It means, in his dwelling place of dead Relia, Cthulhu dreams and waits. Do those words ring any bells?
I've come across the name Cthulhu in old manuscripts concerning primitive religions. Nothing more.
Mr. Parker, man has not always been the master of this world. Many ages ago, there was a race of gods, the great old ones.
But how can you believe such...
I have little time. Rightly or wrongly, many believe that by using certain incantations, these loathsome creatures can be brought back to reign over us once more.
How?
There are portals through which the great old ones will enter in exchange for the promise of power, wealth, and immortality. There are men prepared to perpetuate the hideous ancestral cults and work for the return of these gods.
What are these gods? Where are they?
They are at once far away and very near. Their names are Dagon, Yog-Sothoth, Nyarlathotep, Cthulhu. There are many others. The passing of Halley's comet coincides with a favorable astral conjuncture. They will return. Parker, you must stop them. You must. Do you hear me?
How can I stop them?
In two nights from now, in the center of a stone circle, the guardian of the portal will materialize. It must not be allowed to happen. You will find here a book called the Necronomicon. Within its cursed pages, you will find the formula you need. Be warned, Parker. The book drives men to madness. Do not take it from here.
But if you...
My desk. The message. That man will help you. Some of Illsmouth's citizens will seek your destruction by whatever means possible. Read the message in the safety of your room.
But...
Noracomus, the sorcerer, even dead, he wields ghastly power.
Dead?
Remember, more things in heaven and earth, Horatio, than are dreamt of in your philo...
I won't forget, Tobias Jug. The Necronomicon. I'll need a key to get this book open. This little key must open the lock on this book. The ancients were. The ancients are. The ancients will be. Yog-Sothoth knows the portal. Yog-Sothoth is the portal. Yog-Sothoth is the guardian and the key to the portal. To summon him, stand inside the circle at the appointed hour. Yagnai, Thefaik, Nagha, Yog-Sothoth. Three times he must be summoned, and there will be light. The portal will shut. Put it back in its place. De Vermis Mysteriis, of the Closeness of Shadows, a study of the preaching of Laurent, known as the Visionary. De Vermis Mysteriis. The Book Which Drives Men to Madness, by John Seller. Written on the night of March 1st, under the protection of the seven-branched pentacle. Unspeakable Cults by... That's odd. The name is inked out. 1743. 3. 1743. Occult Practices and Demonic Works, by Theobald of Sion. The Myth of the Beginnings of St. Patrick. The Shadow of Ghouls. The Tiara of Madness, by Michael Roy. What sinister reading matter! Help you lives where the three colors float. From there, 100 messages leave. He's recently been looking for the forgotten symmetry, which is on the map everybody can see. Now, where have I seen a map of the region? And what are these three colors and 100 messages?
Mr. Parker, how about a drink with poor old Jed?
I'd love to, but a little later. I'm in something of a hurry.
Another time, then.
Good day, Miss Gilchrist. I was told there's a map of the region hanging up here, but I can't seem to...
Oh, well, David Underhouse asked me for it, and I lent it to him. The poor man can't get around, you know. Such a cruel world.
Where can I find him?
There! The door at the end! Interested in Indians, are you? Mr. Underhouse is very keen. He's been looking for that cemetery for months.
I beg your pardon?
The cemetery of some Indian tribe, the Muckamucks or something. Well, he found it, and my, is he happy. Now why should a fine man like that take such an interest in savages?
As for savagery, I think the Indians might have learned a thing or two from the 7th Cavalry.
Mr. Parker, my father often said, the only good Indian's a dead one, and he knew what he was talking about. Now, if you'll excuse me, some of us have work to do.
Thank you for defending the Indians, Mr. Parker. No, the walls don't have ears. They are merely very thin. I believe you want to consult the map of this region. Please, go right ahead.
I'm very grateful, Mr. Underhouse.
So, Mr. Parker, why don't we discuss the Micmac?
I'm afraid I didn't make myself very clear. It's precisely because I'm so ignorant about Indian culture that I'm here. Have you heard of Narakamas?
Indeed. He was the last of a particular branch of the Micmac tribe. A branch known as They Who Worship the Night Howler. By Night Howler they meant Nyarlathotep. How did you hear about him?
We met. He almost killed me.
He is supposed to have died 70 years ago.
I can only tell you what happened.
I know it's none of my business, but may I ask what you're looking for on the map?
Do you know this place here?
That's the Stone Circle, the location of the Micmac burial ground. And you say you know nothing of Indian culture?
Does the name Cthulhu mean anything to you?
Let me answer you with a question of my own. Did you know that those who worship Nyarlathotep are rewarded with a very particular gift? Immortality?
Do you think that...
There are names it is wise never to pronounce, and people it is wise never to meet.
Are you talking about the Hambleton family?
An ancient curse hangs over Ilsmouth. Some of the townspeople practice strange rituals in the worship of foul and age-old gods. I wanted to know more, and my curiosity cost me my legs.
And Tobias Jugg, who led me to you, is dead.
Dead? Dear God, there is no time to lose. Andrew Arlington isn't here. The diary containing the origin of the curse is locked inside his office safe.
I'll get the diary and bring it.
No. You'd better leave it where it is. There's no point in alerting them, is there? I can give you some information. I know the combination to the safe is made up of a number of digits.
You don't happen to know what they are?
When I discovered it, just before my accident, the digits had something to do with the Bible.
Well, thank you for your help.
You can thank me by bringing me a photo of the stone circle.
That's a promise. Good morning, ladies.
Hello, Mr.
Gloria, I forbid you to speak to this person. He is nothing more than a ruffian who fights in the streets.
That's a little unfair, Miss Picot. Young Webster needed some help, and it was my duty as a Christian to...
Good Christians do not spend their time in bars, Mr. Parker. Good day to you.
Please forgive me if my behavior upsets you. Would you mind if I borrowed your Bible?
I hardly like to be without it. This Bible is the last reminder of my great-aunt, a most God-fearing woman.
I just dropped in to say hello.
That's very kind of you. I just received a magnificent brooch, imitation silver and gold. Very cheap, $2. I also have a pretty locket at $1. What do you think?
I'll take everything.
Thank you. Come back soon.
Don't try buying my respect with worthless shiny baubles. How kind of you, Mr. Parker. It's almost like the one I lost last week. I don't know how to thank you. Here is my Bible. Please take good care of it.
Page 345. The Apocalypse according to St. John, chapter 13, verse 8. And the number of the beast is 666.
You'll have to come back later. This is my break.
I simply want a few words with the mayor.
Not possible. The mayor is not here at this time.
I don't want to bother you, but the mayor suggested I enjoy the view of Ilsmouth from his office window.
Ah, yes. You must be the photographer. It's about the next edition of the Ilsmouth Town Hall Journal, I suppose.
No, I'm the reporter.
Well, all right. But don't go touching anything. Reporters. They can't leave anyone alone.
There's a handle hidden in this painting. Let's see. It's exactly as I thought. why don't I unscrew this case? What's this inside? A piece of paper.
My name's Jonas. Jonas Hambleton. In 1829, I made my fortune, the hard way, at sea. Even the big Boston businessmen were jealous of my fishery. At that time, I became interested in the occult. I read only the most accursed books. And then, I met Narakamas. He initiated me into the ancient practices. At last, I was in contact with those from the outside. Each day, my knowledge grew deeper. My body regenerated. My hands were at last palmed. But the ancients wanted more. Much more. I gave in. My own wife, Lavina, was the bargain, you see. I screamed out the invocations, and he came. The sea would take all I cherished, but that was of no importance. The pitiless god Dagon wanted that union. That was the price of my immortality. Two sons were born of that wondrous night, Wilbur and Curtis. The second of them betrayed and abandoned me, but the first followed in my footsteps. He has my gift. He can beg to the stones. They all think I'm dead. Only he who reaches that place where water, earth, and sky come together can find my burial place. Our work was destroyed in 1834, all because of that accursed Boleskin. But gods are immortal, and time means nothing to me. Nobody can destroy the families without the statuettes which I guard, and the secret incantation. In 1910, the comet will come again, and the prophecy will come true. Cthulhu Nigga! The great ancients will reign. I will swim beside my Lavina in the abyss, and we shall sing the praises of he who cannot be named.
I'll put the diary back in its place.
Thank you.
So, you're on an errand for Mr. Hambleton. That'll be $3, please. That must be a frock. Mr. Hambleton always orders them from Boston.
Thank you. Good day. Shouldn't be disturbed here.
Ah, hello, Mr. Wilbur. Everything okay? We can go. Mr. Wilbur is there.
Nobody. I think I'll take these ridiculous clothes off. Sundial with a metal point at the center. I have the feeling that the point serves some purpose. Well, well, a mechanism which opens. Thank you. Why not use the wax from this candle to strengthen the wing? Let's hope it holds. Now, let's just hope this thing works. Otherwise... Where am I?
Have no fear, Mr. Parker. You are safe now.
Thank you.
You were the only one brave enough to act. Do you feel better?
Yes, thank you.
God be with you. The danger is great for you. We spent the night in that accursed forest, and we heard the devilish chanting. We saw Mr. Wilbur.
Be quiet, Pepto. I can help you. I can make the shadows speak, the shadows that wander in other worlds. They may be of help to you.
Well, if you think so, go ahead.
Sit down facing me, Mr. Parker. Concentrate. Empty your mind of stray thoughts.
Lord Alistair Bulliskin, you have followed in my footsteps. Now you must destroy the curse of Cthulhu. Long ago, when Illsmouth had no name. Stood beside the shore. A sorcerer perpetrated barbarous sacrifices in the name of the great ancients. The walls amplified the chants of the blood-crazed adepts. Pleasure in our suffering. They have not forgotten the splendor they once knew. If you do not act in two nights, when the comet passes, then the world will once more be enslaved to these loathsome gods. be permitted to return. What I did 76 years ago, you must do. I will help you. But first, you must fight the men who give themselves over to these abominable rites. You must fight alone. One day, the ancient city toppled to the bottom of the ocean. Only thoughtless fools imagine the curse has been lifted for eternity. Of that accursed city, only a stone circle remains. There, the surviving members of the cult meet for their hideous rituals. The great ancients impatiently await the day when they will reconquer their lost kingdom. His city of dead Relia, Cthulhu dreams and waits. None may gaze upon the face of the gods and hope to keep his sanity. Now you must go to where Jonas rests for all eternity.
You must leave now. Remember, nothing is written forever. Believe in yourself. Thank you.
Bishop.
Good evening. You heard the news?
No. What is it?
Jug is dead. Bags discovered his body. Dr. Cobble says it was suicide. And I don't really believe that.
It's horrible.
Yes. I'll say goodbye. I was going to get the cemetery key.
Could you lend me the cemetery key? I would like a few moments there to collect my thoughts.
Sure. Take it. Thank you.
three times. Around the earth, the sun will turn.
You cannot win. You dare trouble my sleep. And for that, you must pay the price.
Listen carefully, Jonas. Your sleep will soon be eternal. Do you hear me?
Your blood will be mine! Yay!
It's all over for you, Jonas. I'm going to destroy you and your filthy kind.
Thank heavens you are safe.
Thank you for saving my life.
He's exhausted. Walter, help me. We'll take him to the house. Do not struggle. No harm will come to you here.
I don't know how to thank you.
My son Walter told me of your adventure the other evening.
I really must go.
such impatience. You must rest a little, and tell me of your adventure. Walter, hand over the tripod you took from Mr. Parker, and leave us, please. I would prefer all this to remain our secret. My son is easily impressed.
Horrible events are taking place in Ilsmouth. If I don't put a stop to them very soon, then even more ghastly things will happen. How lucky I was that you were there.
Take care of the graveyard. We heard the noise. It's not the first time folks have taken an interest in that grave.
Really?
My husband John, God rest his soul, told me of dreadful things before he passed on. We were newlyweds when Jonas died. John went to the Hamilton house for the wake.
Do they still live there?
No. After the fishery went bust and Jonas died, they moved closer to the harbor. Jonas's body was laid out on the top floor of the house. At that time, there was a window in the wall. John looked through, and what he saw was a desert with giant stones and strange creatures.
My God!
John was frightened. He lowered his eyes. On the ground was the sign. Wilbur, who was standing over his father's body, seemed ill at ease. He covered over the sign with a sheet. Well, do you know? The sign shone through the sheet. After that, the window was bricked up.
The sign must have something to do with the curse. If I can place the statuettes on... Let me explain. There are in Ilsmouth four families who are trying to help some unspeakably evil gods to return to this world. The gods are called the Great Ancients, and they ruled the world many thousands of years ago. To destroy these families, I must place these four statuettes on their houses. Strange words are engraved on the bases of these statuettes.
Who are these families?
Arlington, Hambleton, Coldstone, and Tyler.
I know that Walter hid a drawing of the sign around here. It was a kind of cross, I think. We must find it. I'll look near the fireplace.
Mrs. Webster, come quick. I found it.
Please, hurry, Mr. Parker. There isn't much time.
A drawing of a star.
Keep away from Jonas Hamilton's house. There's a good chance they're waiting for you there. They need to be weakened first.
You think they already know?
I'm sure of it. Good luck to you, Mr. Parker, and may God go with you.
Not that, Parker, please!
Good God, how horrible!
Oh, Dagon, I beg you, from the depths of the abyss, come to my aid! Fill me with the power of the age-old curse!
They're trying that on me, Parker. You're gravely mistaken if you imagine you can eliminate me.
Rala! Gana! Haas! Tik! Rala! Gana! Haas! Tik!
No! Not that!
No, Parker. Not that. I beg you.
Good God, how ghastly.
Cthulhu, help thy faithful servant.
Naga! Hulu! Kau! Wig Naga! Hulu! Kau! Wig!
Not that! Ah! Parker! Have mercy! Not that! Please tell me you won't do that!
Dear God, how abominable.
Yogg-Sothoth, may your demonic power guide my corrupted soul.
The dog's barking. He must be here.
Mm-hmm.
a book called Magic Rites. We've got him. Now we'll have some fun. Right, Dad?
You'll pay for this.
Impossible! Mercy, Parker! Parker!
Curse you!
A curse on you for Elea! Fagathan Iahe Cthulhu Ea!
Why have you all abandoned me? I curse you, Parker. You will not... Cthulhu! Dagon! Yon! Sombol!
Feeling that without you,
Mr. Parker, could you tell me what you were doing last night in Jonas Hambleton's house?
No, I couldn't tell you.
That's all very well, but...
What about if I told you I was acting in the interest of the whole community? Would you believe me?
Yes. I think I would believe you. I have lived in Ilsmuth too long not to know of some terrible things.
Doctor, if everything goes to plan, the evil shadow that hangs over Ilsmuth will soon be a mere memory.
You are right. These things have something to do with the comet, don't they?
Yes, tonight's the night.
there is precious little time to be lost. Last night's events caused quite a stir. I was called upon this morning to practice an autopsy on the body of Andrew Arlington. For a few moments, I almost lost my mind.
And Bags?
He understands nothing. By the way, be careful. He's looking for you.
I had gathered that much.
I must leave you. Duty calls. Good luck, Mr. Parker. Ah, Miss Gilchrist gave me this for you.
Thank you, Doctor. Come right away. I have made some important discoveries. H. Underhouse. Good evening.
Bless my soul, it's you, Mr. Parker. You gave me quite a turn. Have you heard what happened last night?
Dr. Carville told me all about it this morning.
What a carry-on. I'm still under shock. Such screams! I don't suppose you've seen my niece.
I'm afraid I haven't, no.
That little flibbertigibbet is up to Lord only knows what kind of mischief. I'm so worried. You really should pay us a visit, you know. Gloria would be most touched.
That won't be possible today, I'm afraid.
Oh, well, no matter. Goodbye, Mr. Parker.
Is Mr. Underhouse in?
Good day, ma'am. Oh, forgive me. With all these goings on, I'm quite flustered. Mr. Underhouse is expecting you.
Looking for you. I want some explanations about last night.
I'm all yours. If you'd care to come to Mr. Underhouse's apartment, we'll be able to talk.
Let's go.
Hello, Mr. Underhouse.
Sorry for bothering you. You want wanted to talk to me somewhere where we wouldn't be overheard.
Be my guests, gentlemen.
Okay. Now, where were you last night, Parker?
Well...
Sergeant, we spent the evening together. If you want more precise details, we talked about Indians.
You're sure about that, Mr. Underhouse?
Yesterday, I gave my key to Mr. Parker. We talked until 3 o'clock in the morning. By the way, we noticed something unusual. We saw Zeke hanging around Coldstone's place. That must have been about midnight.
Zeke? My informer? So he tried to trick me. He's the brains behind this whole plot? I'm really sorry, Mr. Parker. That Zeke is going to pay for this, I'm telling you.
You did me a very great favor.
You must act quickly. Bags will eventually realize that Zeke is not the mastermind he imagines him to be. Tonight is the night of the comet. Naracinus must not be allowed to intervene. His power is considerable.
Sacred bow and arrow. They belong to the youngest. His accursed family lives from the sea. The bow is hidden where the fire lives. The feather on the wood will fly towards me. I don't understand.
The feather belongs to Indian tradition. As for the bow and arrow, you'll have to find them.
Well, I'll do my best. Where does this Naracinus live?
Natawanga will tell you. Be on your way. And don't forget my photo of the stone circle.
I won't.
Thank you.
going to see Curtis. Something tells me he's not at home.
Oh?
I went to see him, to see if he needed anything. I knocked on the door. No answer.
He's probably a heavy sleeper, that's all.
His door is locked, and that's very unusual. He could be at his old friend Greenwood's. I'd sure like to know where he is. With all the strange happenings, I'm kind of worried. Goodbye, Mr. Parker.
Was cleverly hidden.
Hello? Is there anybody there?
What do you want?
Underhouse sent me. I need help. I must kill Narakamas.
You found me. Do you have the sacred bow and arrow?
Here they are.
Good. But first, I must be sure that you are ready. Tell me the name of Narakamus' tribe. What is the name of the tribe Narakamus belongs to?
The Micmacs.
What is the name of he who howls in the night?
Yog-Sothoth.
In what year did Balaskin see the comet?
...1834.
What shape is the sign of the four families?
A star.
And what is the creature that erupts from the depths of the sea at night?
Dagon.
You have answered well. What do you know of Narakamas?
He is a very powerful wizard. He is said to be almost immortal.
Ha! You know many things. And few things. You have willpower and courage. That is important.
Where can I find him?
At Ilsmuth, an eye is open. It is set deep in the earth. All day, that is where Narakamas sleeps.
Will the task be easy?
Do not think that. He is awake now. His power is great. Only the fire you will bring forth from the earth can help. Use it in the demon's home. It will protect you.
Thank you.
Now you must set out. The turquoise sun is already in the sky. Soon night will fall. Prepare to leave the world you know. You will go where nothing of your world has meaning.
Will I die?
You may, but if you succeed, you must scatter the comet's shadow. This ring will help you. Find its stone. If you need an object for your quest, have it with you before the time of testing. I will be with you in your ordeal.
Thank you.
This well is about as dank as you can get. I'll get down. In hell.
Fatang! Cthulhu! Aeea!
It is pointless to resist, Narakamus. This is for Jug. Say hello to Satan for me.
Cthulhu!
Parker, listen to me.
Good grief, Lord Boliskin.
What I began 76 years ago, you will finish. You must seal the great ancient's access to this world. On the island sleeps Dagon. He who reigns in the depths of the seas. You must find a boat and go there. You will fight evil by resuscitating the symbol of death.
But?
May your courage stay with you in the demon's presence. I will help you twice more.
This stone is just the right size. Let's see. If I put a stone in there...
walk, Mr. Parker.
I was hoping I'd run into you.
One always finds what one seeks, Mr. Parker.
Have you ever visited that small island off the coast?
The island? No one ever sets foot on it. Everybody knows it's...
Do not be blinded by ridiculous superstition.
How can you of all people say such a thing? You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
No, they are stronger than we are.
Would you mind telling me exactly what you want, Mr. Parker?
Lend me your rowing boat.
Why didn't you say so? Take it, and the best of luck to you, my boy.
Thank you.
your struggle against the gods is not over. Get back to the boat. The currents will take you to the cavern.
Who must I fight now?
A sanctuary in Cthulhu's honor has been erected. You will need all your mental powers. Here is my ring. It will serve you, even though the stone is missing.
How?
You will find out. You have already put your finger on the solution. And bear in mind the Bulliskin family motto. For God and the green land of my fathers, go and destroy that thing born of the flames of hell.
Let's try this emerald. Bulliskin's ring. Why don't I put a stone in it? As dark as the deepest corners of hell. I just hope there's enough oil left in the lamp. Curses! No oil left.
I beg you, Mr. Parker, help us out of here!
Okay, I'll put this ring on my right hand. Okay, I'll put this ring on my left hand.
Can I thank you, Mr. Parker? I didn't think we would ever be free again.
No need for thanks, Ellen. Get away from here. Don't wait for me. I must finish the task.
Fothongjar, Malach, Ai, Ralaya, Ai, Jar, Naga, Fothongjar, Cthulhu, Yagar, Ralaya. The door is blocked. You have just enough time to get to the stone circle. A word of advice. First, you must photograph the comet.
I'm not sure I can.
I know you will succeed, but hurry. The comet does not wait.
What's that back there? A small passage. Let's take off the wrapping. The colored patches on this butterfly are translucent. I wonder why. Jerg certainly knew how to guard his secrets. I'll put the butterfly into the camera. This magnifying glass is a perfect fit for my telescope. The comet's going to cross at any moment. Aquamarine symbolizes water, thus the color blue. Flint symbolizes fire, thus the color red. The comet symbolizes air, thus the color white. The diamond symbolizes earth, thus the color green. Yognai, Thothok, Naga, Yog-Sothoth. Yognai, Thothok, Naga, Yog-Sothoth. Yognai, Thothok, Naga, Yog-Sothoth.
Your mission's over, Parker. Your courage and willpower have sealed off Illsmouth to the great ancients. But remember, nothing's over. It can all start again somewhere else. But... I must return to the Kingdom of Shadows. My task is over. I have shown you the way, but always remember this. That is not dead which can eternal lie.
Well, I'd better be getting down to the harbor. My boat should be leaving soon. I'd better get my equipment into the trunk. The driver will soon be here. Everything's ready. I'll take my leave. It's odd that the doctor is out. I expected more from him. Perhaps he has better things to do.
Offensive, I'll be glad to see the last of you. You've turned the village into a morgue. I put Zeke in the slammer just in case. Well, I'm going to check if those gypsies have moved out. Goodbye, Parker. And if I never see you again, it's soon enough for me.
Interesting character, that Bags. What are you all doing here?
Dear Mr. Parker, I'm not much of a hand at making speeches.
That's a joke. He talked for 2 hours at the Temperance League meeting.
Jed Donahue, will you kindly let the doctor get on with it? Well, doctor, we're waiting.
Thank you. Well, as I was saying...
What was I saying?
Oh, yes. Well, here we are, gathered together.
Even Swing managed to find time to get away from his break to be here.
You're speaking ill of a public official.
Will you let me get on with this? There. Well, to get to the point, we want to say...
Thank you! Thank you!
Oh, well... To be honest...
There is no more to be said. You've scattered the comet's shadow. That's something we can never forget. Now you'd better get going.
Your boat won't wait.
Goodbye.
Hey, find a fine old pub and drink to my health. Goodbye, Parker.
I might just do that, Jed.
Thanks again for the photo of the stone circle.
My pleasure.
The competition is going to hate my guts, and will prove the Bullerskin was right. What was it he saw exactly?
It's a long story, and I'm not sure...
Long stories are my favorite kind. Go ahead. I'm listening.
Well, Mr. Griffith, what do you know of Cthulhu?